The center has stuck to its position on Rohingya minorities. Today, it told the Supreme Court that Rohingyas are a threat to national security and a drain on India's resources and hence need to be deported. Of course, we're talking about the Rohingya minorities who've migrated from Myanmar, where they claim to be persecuted and subjected to violence. I have with me Apurva, Vishwananth, who are a legal expert whose work all of you have followed. Apurva, can you tell us what did the center exactly say in its affidavit today?
So the 16-page document is essentially telling the court why the Rohingyas cannot continue to live in India. So of course the national security issue is reiterated, and they also talk about how Rohingyas, being an immigrant, illegal migrant in India, cannot approach the Supreme Court for fundamental rights. So a lot of issues, basically reiterating their stand on, you know, the whole thing.
But is there any credible report, any data that they are stating to back their claims about them being a threat to national security? Because we've not seen any reports so far.
Interestingly, Ruhi, as of now, there is nothing that the Supreme Court has seen so far. The center has said that there are militant elements within the Rohingyas in Jammu, Delhi, Hyderabad and Mewar, where they have their camps. And they have links with ISIS and also with ISI. But on 3rd of October, it is expected that the center will file an affidavit, another in probably a sealed envelope,
right,
to the court, saying how they've got security inputs on these issues.
Right. Well, the center is of course taking what we can consider a pragmatic stand on the issue, but there is a humanitarian aspect to it as well, which is perhaps more important. And we know the NHRC has decided to take this up.
Absolutely.
What is the legal route that the NHRC can pursue?
So, the NHRC chief was the former Chief Justice of India, H.L. Dattu. He's, as we know, he has said that if required, they will approach the court and become a party. Because since there is a humanitarian issue, NHRC will have locus before the court and they will also be party in the dispute. So as we go ahead, when the court begins hearing the issue in detail, NHRC will be asked to give their own report on it.
Right. Well, can you explain this to us in the context of international law? I know we have not, we're not signatories to the UN Convention on Refugees, but does that still put any onus on us?
So public international law is broader than just this one convention. So for example, there's the International Convention on Torture, which does not allow, which we are a signatory to, and that doesn't allow us to deport a particular community or an individual back to their country when they know they will be tortured back, you know, in their home country.
Right.
So apart from this, there are a lot of conventions which will have an effect on the Indian government. But interestingly, the central government hasn't stated its position on that as of now.
Right.
Right now, they've stuck to national security issues, very pragmatic, like you said, and only in the time to come, we will see more of these international law-related issues.
Right. Well, finally, Apurva, we've seen how India has traditionally welcomed refugees, really. We've given refuge to Tibetans, to Afghans, to Sri Lankan Tamils. How can the center place its stand on the Rohingyas in that perspective? I mean, how can it explain why they are being singled out?
If you look at the government's affidavit today, they say that their first obligation is to the citizens of India and not to the Rohingyas.
Right.
So in that context, what they believe is that this particular migrant community is a threat to India's national security. Drain on resources, well, I don't think they can stick to that stand as much,
right,
given our history with refugees.
Right.
But just on the national security issue, the government stand has been consistent, and they've been saying it time and again that Indian citizens will be at peril if they accept Rohingyas, the 40,000 odd Rohingyas, to live in India.
Right, of course, to be sure, Minister of State for Home, Kiran Rijiju, had also made this statement much earlier. He very publicly said the same thing. So as you said, the government is sticking to its stand.
But we'd also like to clarify this thing to our viewers that although the affidavit filed today is by a Home Ministry official, the centre has reserved its final decision on the issue.
Right.
They have said in this affidavit that's been filed today that they're just stating facts, that they're stating their point of view, but only on October 3rd that they will come up with their final stand on the issue.
Right. Well, that was Apurva, who put in perspective what really happened in court and what the centre, how the centre presented a stand to the Supreme Court on the Rohingya refugee issue. As she said, we'll know more only on the 3rd of October. Thank you so much for watching.